5 of the 7. 2 horns and 1 strike. Roughing stretches and roughing pitches. Caught the inside corner, steam right 1. And a baby no batter up there. 1 out. A man on second. 5 of the 7. 2 balls and 1 strike. Roughing stretches. Roughing pitches. Low one outside. Ball 3. Come on, right, make him a hitter. In there all the
time.
Hey,
please, my head is splitting.
I told that boy 109 times. Eugene, stop banging the wall.
And a minimum, this is for the World Series. 1 out. A man on 7. 5 of the 7. 3 balls and 1 strike. Roughing stretches. And pitches. Oh no! High and outside! JoJo Moore walks first and second, and Mel Alope's up to the plate!
Can't he do that someplace else?
Oh, Greg is on. That's where he'll do it. Eugene, I'm not gonna tell you again. Do you hear me?
It's the last batter Mel Melon is up. It's a crucial moment in World Series history.
Your Aunt Blanche has a splitting headache.
I always does it when I'm studying. I have to be
crazy. One thing, Mom. I think I can get the pop up. I have my stuff today.
Your father will give you plenty of stuff when he comes home, you hear?
All right.
I want you inside now. Put out the water gun.
I can do that.
Why? Is his arm broken? And I don't want any back talk, you hear?
Attention, ladies, and gentlemen. Today's game will be delayed, late. Because my Aunt Blanche is heading.
Blanche, that's enough song already. Since 7 o'clock this morning.
I just have this one edge to finish. Lori, darling, why don't you help me and Kate with the dishes?
2 more pages, all right, Mom? I have to finish the Macedonian Wars.
Always studying that one. She's gonna have some head on her shoulders. Eugene!
I'm coming!
And wash your hands!
They're clean. I'm wearing a glove. I hate my name. Eugene Morris Jerome. It's the second worst name of the giving pool male child. The first worst is Haskell Fleischman. How am I ever gonna play for the Yankees with a name like Eugene Morris Jerome? You have to be a Joe, or a Tony, or a Frankie. All the best Yankees are Italian. My mother made spaghetti with ketchup. What chance do I have?
I'm almost through, Mom.
All right, darling. You have better color today, sweetheart. Did you get a little sun this morning?
I'm down to the beach.
Very slowly,
yes,
I hope.
Mom.
She gets all this special treatment because the doctors say she's got a kind of flutter in her heart. Why, I got hit with a baseball, right in the back of the skull. So I cooled everything for a week, and I still had to carry a block of ice home every afternoon. Girls are treated like queens. Maybe that's what I should have been born, an Italian girl.
Eugene!
What?
How many times have I told you not to leave your things around the house?
109.
What?
You said to me yesterday, I called you 109 times not to leave your things around the house.
Don't be fresh with your mother, Gene.
Was I fresh? I swear to God, that's what she said to me yesterday. One of these days, I'm gonna put this all down in a book or a play. Why, I'm gonna be a writer. Like Ringlaud or somebody. But that's if things don't work out first with the Yankees. Or the Cubs. Or the Red Sox, and maybe possibly the Tigers. But if I get down to those St. Louis Browns, I'll definitely be a writer.
Mom, can I have a glass of lemonade?
It'll spoil your dinner, darling.
Can you believe that? She better have a bad heart, or I'm gonna kill one of these things. Listen, I hope you don't repeat this to anybody, but what I'm telling you are my secret memoirs. It's called The Unbelievable, Fantastic, and Completely Private Thought Divine, Eugene Morris Jerome, and this, the 15 year of my life, in the year 1937, community of Brighton Beach, borough of Brooklyn, Kings County, City of New York, Empire State of the American Nation.
A roller skate on my kitchen floor. Do you want me dead? Is that what you want?
I didn't leave it there.
No, then who? Lori and Blanche, do you ever see them on skates? Take this upstairs. Come here. Blind eye,
whatever. Don't hit my skull, I got a concussion.
What would you tell your father if he came home and I was lying dead on the kitchen floor?
I'd say, don't go in the kitchen, Bob!
Get upstairs! And don't come down with dirty hands.
see why I want to write this all down? In case I grow both twisted and warped, the world will know why.
He's a boy. He's young. He should be happy, he's healthy, and active. Before the doctors found out what Lori had, she was the same way.
Never. Girls are different. When you and I were girls, we kept the house spotless. It was Ben and Ezra who drove Mama crazy. I've always been like that. I've always had to have things clean, just like Mama. The day they packed up and left the house in Russia, she said, no matter what the Cossacks did to us, when they broke into her house, they would have respect for the Jews.
Who are the Cossacks?
The same filthy bunches live across the street.
Across the street? You mean the Mikeys?
All of them.
The Mikeys are Russian?
Their mother is nice. She's been very sweet to me.
Her windows are so filthy, I thought she had black curtains hanging inside.
I was in her house. It was very neat. Nobody could be as neat as you, though.
What business did you have in their
house?
She's
marrying me for
to meet that drunken son of hers?
No, just the two of us.
I am living here 7 years. She never invited me for tea because she knows your situation. I know their kind. Remember what Mommy used to tell us? Stay on your own side of the street. That's what they have gutters for.
That's what they had gutters for.
If my mother knew I was writing all this down, she'd stuff me like one of the chickens. I better explain what she meant by Aunt Blanche's situation. Do you see a husband? Uncle Lee? He died 6 years ago from this thing. They never see the word. They always whisper it. It was. I think they're afraid if they said it out loud, God would say, I heard that you said the dread disease just for that I smite you down with it. There are some things worlds just won't discuss. Like my grandfather. He died from diphtheria. Anyway, after Uncle Dave died, he left Aunt Blanche with no money. Not even insurance anymore. She can't support herself because she has so my big-hearted mother insisted we take her and the two kids in to live with us. My father thought it would just be temporary, but it's been 3.5 years so far. And I think because of Aunt Blanche's situation, my father's developing high blood pressure.
Here's your lemonade.
Thank you, Aunt Kate.
Drink it slowly. Blanche, that's enough sewing already. That's all I need
is
for you to
go stopping.
You'll sew your fingers together.
It's getting dark anyway. I think I need new glasses.
Would it kill you to put a light on?
I don't have to run up electric bills. I owe you and Jack enough as it is.
Have I asked you for anything? You see anybody starving around here? If I go hungry, you'll give me something from your plate.
Kate, I'm going to pay you and Jack back someday. I don't know when, but I keep my word.
From your lips to the Irish sweepstakes. Go in and taste the soup. See if it needs salt.
Can I get out the water glasses, or is Eugene going to do it?
Eugene, it's the last time I'm gonna tell you. Just do the napkins, darling.
Because of her condition, I could do twice as much work around here. Boy, if I could just make the Yankees, I'd be in St. Petersburg this winter. Her sister Nora is 16. I don't mind her much. At least she's not too bad to look at. To be absolutely honest with all of you, this is the year I started noticing girls that weren't too bad to look at. Nora started developing about 8 months ago, and I have the exact date written in my memoir.
Mama, Lori, Aunt Kate, I've got incredible news!
Hi, Nora!
Eugene, my sweet, adorable, handsome cousin, what do you like to say? What's happened? I'm fainting, I'm absolutely fainting!
I felt the chest! When'd you hug me? I felt my first chest!
Okay, is everybody ready?
That's ready now.
No, I don't think they can. start rehearsing a week from Monday, and then it goes to Philadelphia, Wilmington, Washington, and then it comes to New York the second week in December. There are 9 big musical numbers, and there's a big tag on the stage that you can see through, and the whole finale takes place with the entire cast all underwater. I mean, can you believe it, Mama? I'm gonna be in a Broadway show!
What is she talking about?
Do I know? Am I her mother?
How can you be in a Broadway show? Don't you have to sing and act?
I can sing.
No,
a little.
No,
I can't.
No, you can't.
I probably won't have to.
But I get to sing and act.
Haven't you? You never saw a Broadway show.
Did you tell him how old
he
was?
He didn't ask him.
I am. It's the most fantastic thing I've ever heard.
Thanks, Eugene. I'm glad somebody's excited.
I thought I'll be sitting next door to a show.
How can you go to Philadelphia? What about school?
Mama, this is a Broadway show. This is what I'm going to do with my life. Algebra and English
and English.
Will you stay out of this?
You mean not finish high school? Not get a diploma? Do you know how hard it is for a girl to get a good job without a high school diploma? Never mind. I'll go.
Don't do that.
Don't make me feel guilty.
All right, I'll go.
And get a quarter pound of butter.
I bought a quarter pound of butter this morning, Mom. Now, why don't you try buying half a pound at a time?
And suppose the house burned down this afternoon. What do I need an extra quarter pound of butter for?
If my mother taught logic in high school, this would be one weird country.
So what are you gonna do?
I don't know. Leave me alone. Don't just sit there.
My name is Lori. I don't have to leave.
Do you have to stare at me? Can I have some
stare
privacy?
Can't help it if your body is in tears. I bet you're worried.
How would you feel if your entire life depended on what your Uncle Jack decided? I wish Daddy were alive.
He would have said no. He was really strict.
Not with me. I mean, he was strict, but he was fair. If he said no, he always gave you a good reason. He always talked things out. Wish I could call him somewhere now and ask him what to do. 1 3-minute call to heaven is all I ask.
Ask Mom. She talks to him every night.
Who told you that?
She did. Every night before she goes to bed, she puts his picture on her pillow and talks to him. Then she pulls the blanket halfway up the picture and goes to sleep.
She does.
She does too. Last year when I had the big fever, I slept in the bed with the both of them. In the middle of the night, my face fell on his picture and cut my nose.
She does that. That's weird.
I can't remember him much anymore. I used to remember him real good. Now he disappears a little bit every day.
He was so handsome. Always dressed so dapper. His shoes always shined. I thought he should have been a movie star, like Gary Cooper. Only very short ones. But mostly, I remember his pocket.
His pocket?
When I was 6 or 7, he always used to bring me home little surprises, like a Hershey or a top. He'd tell me to go get it in his coat pocket, so I'd run to the closet and put my hands inside, and it felt as big as a tent. Just wanted to crawl in there and go to sleep. And there were all these terrific things in there, like juicy fruit gums, spearmint lifesavers, crumble pieces of tobacco, movie stubs, pennies, nickels, those raceway gloves he wore in the winter.
What if the coins on the fingers? I remember.
And then I found this coat in Mom's closet, and it was empty. Everything was gone. It was dry cases. It felt cold. And that's when I knew he was really dead. Wish we had our own place to live. I hate being a boarder. Listen, let's make a pact. The first one who makes enough money promises not to spend any on herself, saves it all to get a house for you, me, and Mom. That means every penny we get from now on, we save for the house. We can't buy anything. No lipstick, no magazines, no bubblegum, nothing. Is it packed?
What about the
movies too?
Starting when?
Starting today.
Can
right we
start Sunday? I want to see the
movies.
William Powell and Myrna Loy?
Okay, starting Sunday. I'll go with you Saturday.
I'll be away for this stuff from today. The snow is coming down in the abyss. And he's got it! He's got his own pass! He's running the 50, the 40, the 30, the 20, and the 10, and it's a touchdown! Columbia wins! They defeat the mighty Princeton Bomber 13-12! Listen to that crowd roar! Woo!
Eugene, stop that yelling! I've a cake in the oven!
Hey, Stan. My big brother, Stan. He's okay. He'll like me.
Well, what are you doing else, Lola?
No, did you ask about the tickets?
What tickets?
For the Yankee game. You said your boss knew this guy who gets passes.
Me and my boss had other things to talk about. I'm in trouble, Huge. I'm in really big trouble.
Now, this really shocked me because Stan is the kind of guy who can talk himself into any kind of trouble. The trouble.
I got fired.
Fired? You mean for good?
You don't get fired temporarily. It's permanent. It's a lifetime fire.
Why would I? and knocked the can of lychee all over the table. And it ruined three brand new hats right out of the box. $9 Stetsons. But it wasn't Andrew's fault. I mean, he didn't put lychee on there, right?
Right.
So Mrs. Strawline comes in. He sees the only hats, and he goes crazy. He says to Andrew, the hats are gonna have to come out of his salary. $27. Said Andrew, he started to cry.
He cried?
42 years old, the man's bawling all the stock. Man doesn't have too much furniture upstairs, you know what I mean. But he's really sweet. He always brings me coffee, always laughing, telling jokes. Might not understand them, but I like him a minute. It makes me feel good.
Yeah?
Anyway, I said to Mrs. Strawline, I don't think that's fair. It wasn't Andrew's fault.
You said that to him?
Sure, why not? Said Mrs. Strawline, says,
do you want to pay for the hats, big mouth?
I said, no, I don't want to pay for hats. So then he says,
then mind your own business, big mouth.
Holy mackerel! He's looking at me like there's machine gun bullets coming out of his eyes. Then he calmly sends Andrew over to the factory to pick up three brand new hats, which is usually my job. So guess what Mrs. Strawline tells me to do?
What?
He tells me to sweep up. He says that this week I'm the cleaning guy. I can't believe it. Everyone's watching me now, waiting to see what I'm gonna do. Even Andrew stopped trying to watch. I felt the dignity of every work in that store in the palm of my hands. So then I gripped my teeth, picked up the broom. This is big pile of dirt right in the middle of the floor. Swept it all over his shoes. Andrew just shot him today if you wanna talk about irony.
I'm actually done.
You can see everyone in the place, they're about to bust a gut. Mrs. Mulcahy, the bookkeeper, she can hardly keep a folks' teeth in her mouth. And Andrew's eyes, they're hanging 5 inches out of his socket.
This is the greatest story in the history of the world, Thomas.
So Mrs. Strawline grabs me, throws me into his office, shuts his door, throws down the shades. He gives me this big lecture on how he was raised in Germany to respect his superiors, and that if he had ever did such a thing like you, they would beat me in the cup until they carried me off and dead.
You got him down just perfect, Steve.
And I said, yeah? But we ain't in Germany, old buddy.
You say that to him?
No, to myself. I'm not that too
far. I'm just one of them.
Anyway, Mr. Strawline said he's always liked me, thought I was a good guy. So he's gonna give me one more chance. I've gotta write him a letter of apology. And it's on his desk by 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. I can consider myself fired.
Oh, I had a heart attack.
Are you gonna write the letter?
No.
Positively?
Positively. I just gotta discuss with Pop, because I know we need the money. But he told me when I was young, you gotta do what you think is right in this world. You gotta stand up for your principles.
And what if you think that your principles are wrong? That you should write the letter?
No. No. He's gonna lay up to me.
But
wait, no.
Stanley, write the letter.
Mom? I just won't know that until after dinner, now will we?
All in all, it was shaping up to be one hell of a dinner. I can tell you this, though. I had this cool way thing about my brother, Stan. I either worshipped the ground he walked on, or I hated him so much I wanted to kill him. I guess you know how I feel about it today.
To bring home bread, give Aunt Blanche the butter. She's
I
waiting for 15 it.
Minutes. I was just talking to Stanley.
Hey, I got a letter from Ross and Weena. You remember her. They moved to Manhattan. She lives in Central Park West.
Why not? Her father's a gangster. Her mother is worse. I don't get a kiss hello?
No. I was gonna save it and give you a big one for Christmas.
We don't have Christmas. I'll take it now, thank you. A hug, too? Since when do I get hugs from you? You must have done something wrong.
You're too small for me, Mom. I brought the barber shop.
Is that why you look so tired? You don't get enough sleep running around all night with your 200 girlfriends?
130. That's all, Mom. 130.
How do you get any work done?
I get it done.
And your boss doesn't say anything to you about being tired?
About being tired? No, he doesn't.
Did you ask him about Thursday?
Thursday?
I'm going to ask him about getting paid this Thursday so I can pay three flats on Friday. Saturday is a holiday.
I forgot. I'll ask him tomorrow.
If it's a problem, Green Black can wait. Your boss is more important.
That's not true, Mom. My boss isn't more important than Mr. Green Black.
Oh, God. If the things weren't bad enough, and now this.
People, it's tragic. Liver and cabbage for dinner.
A Jewish medieval torture.
My friend, Monty Gregorio, an A student in science, told me that cooked cabbage can be smelled farther than sound traveling 7 minutes. If these memoirs are never finished, it's because I gagged to death in the middle of supper.
There were all witnesses. I was in right here.
Then I'll get blamed for that anyway.
I'm all right. Just let me sit a minute. Didn't I tell you to get out of that hot kitchen? I can't breathe in there, and I don't have asthma. Nora, Lori, come help your mother.
I'm sick about the plate. I'll replace it. Don't worry about the plate.
Plates I can always get. I only have one.
What happened?
Don't run, Lori. Another asthma attack. It's the second one this week. Nora, maybe we ought to get the doctor.
No doctors.
This is no climate for you near the beach. What you need is someplace.
Lay down, Arizona.
Can I get the doctor?
No, no doctor.
But I can still hear
you.
Nora, go up and get your mother's medicine. Lori, you sit there quiet and watch your mother. You look pale as a ghost. Eugene, come in here and help me.
Hello, Mrs. Preston. How are you today?
In a minute, Mom. Popsole. I would now like to introduce my father, a real hard worker. He was born at the age of 42. Hey, Pop, how you doing, Pop?
How am I doing?
Let me keep this inside for you, Pop.
No, that's too heavy. You'll hurt yourself.
No, I just need a good grip, that's all.
Let me just sit a while.
You okay, Pop?
I'm resting on this hall. Want to give me a glass of ice water?
You know, Amos and Andy is on tonight.
You would do your homework, then we'll discuss Amos and Andy.
Here's your menu, Mom. Lori, go get a glass of water. Lori shouldn't be running.
I'll get it, Nora.
You sure you don't mind?
No, we don't have a little. 1.5 seconds, here's all I need.
When are you going to talk to Uncle Jack, Mom?
When I talk to him,
Eugene said you were holding your chest.
I wasn't holding my chest.
You have to carry that box every day, back and forth to the city. You don't work hard enough, Jack.
You want the box? Take it. It's yours. I don't need it anymore.
What do you mean?
Delamar's party favors went out of business. They closed them out. The man is bankrupt.
Oh, my God.
He never even warned me it was coming.
You told me he lived up on Riverside Drive with a view of a river. A $300 a month apartment he had. A man like that.
We're the ones who think go bankrupt. We live in a cold water flat on Delancey Street. Bankruptcy is the one thing God spares us.
All right. You can always find good in something. You don't have to love that box anymore. And you don't have to get up at 5:30 in the morning. We can all eat dinner at a decent hour. You still have your job with Jacobson. We won't.
I can't make ends meet with what I'm making for Jacobson's. Not with 7 people to feed.
They'll hear you. We'll talk later.
I can't get by without that extra $25 a week. I can't pay rent and insurance and food and clothing for 7 people. Christmas and New Year's alone, I only made $150.
Stop it, Jack. You'll only get yourself sick.
He never even paid me for the week, the bastard. 5 salesmen are laid off, and he's going to a Broadway show tonight. I stuffed every hat and noisemaker I could into that box, and at his funeral, I'll put on a pointy hat and blow a horn, the bastard.
Don't talk like that. Something will come up. You go to temple this weekend, and you'll pray all day Saturday.
There's men going to their temple for over 40 years. Do you know how many prayers have got to get answered before they get to mine?
Your turn will come up.
God has time for everybody.
Here's your water, Aunt Blanche.
Thank you, darling.
Where's Laura?
Went up to Paul Stanley for dinner.
Hey, Laura, you feel like taking a walk on the beach tonight?
I have homework. What do you want to walk with me for?
Oh, I just felt like taking a walk with, me, you, and Laura, that's all.
I think Nora had a date with Larry Clurman.
Larry Clurman? She likes Larry Clurman?
I don't know. Ask me
himself. Larry Clurman's my father's age.
He's 20.
Same thing. You think he's good looking?
I don't think anybody's good looking.
Larry Clurman? He doesn't even have a chin. He wears his tie all the way up to his teeth.
Eugene, where's your father's water?
I'm coming. Now I've got Larry Clurman to contend with. Here's your water, Pop.
Don't drink so fast.
Pop, you think you got a second to take a look at my sneakers?
What does he want to look at your sneakers for?
They have no soles. They're hanging on by a tiny piece of rubber. When I go out for a flight ball, I gotta cringe my toes.
I bought your new sneakers last month.
Last year, not last month, Pop. I can only wear them 2 hours a day because my toes can't grow it.
In the rain? He was out there when I went to get the milk.
He's got a good paying job, lives alone with his mother, so he takes a drink on a Saturday night. Maybe what he needs is a good woman.
Not my sister. Let him find someone lying in the next doorway. I don't want to discuss this anymore.
Come in.
Are you busy? I wanted to talk to you.
That's funny. I want to talk to you, too.
About what?
I need a favor, really bad. You're the only one that can help me.
What is it?
And you'll say, now there's a Minnesota for his principles.
I have my own things to bring up at dinner. I don't want to get into a discussion about what
his
family.
Not his whole life, just his principles.
Why would I do such a stupid thing?
Oh, you know why? As of tomorrow, I am unemployed, unless someone besides me mentions sticking up for their principles.
What happened? Did you get fired?
I will be unless I write Kaiser Wilhelm a letter of apology. I'm really leaving it up to my own man. Decide to do what I'd be told to me.
When are you gonna ask him?
Tonight, right after dinner.
Tonight? Does it have to be tonight?
Yeah, that's a deadline. I think I'm gonna ask Mr. Strong tomorrow.
Couldn't you ask your father in the morning?
No, he gets up at 5:30. My mom has to line up his shoes tonight because he can't make decisions that early. What's wrong, man?
I don't know what you have to complain about. At least your father is allowed you around the house to make decisions. Sometimes you don't know when you're well off, Stanley. You make me.
The infamous dinner.
Nora Stanley, time for dinner.
It started out like a murder mystery in Blenheim Castle. No one said a word, but everyone looked suspicious.
I
so quiet, you can hear the soup going down Lori's esophagus. Everyone had one eye on their plate and their other eye on top. Except me. I sat absent Nora, and I kept dropping my napkin a lot, so I could bend down and get a good look at those creamy white virginal lips. She was really deep in thought sometimes, because she left herself unguarded. And I got to see halfway up the thighs that led to the Golden Palace of the Himalayas.
Eugene, keep your napkin on your lap and stop daydreaming.
Imagine.
WBS presents Dinner at Brighton Beach, starring the Jacob Jerome family in this week's special days.
Liver and cabbage.
Brought to you by X-Lax tomorrow.
The whole country's gonna hear about a 15-year-old boy gagging on liver.
No one has anything to discuss. Otherwise, I'm gonna go turn on the news.
Actually, as a matter of fact...
What?
Nothing. I'll help with the dishes.
You sit there and finish your lunch.
I can't swallow it, Mom. I'll go down.
Do you want to see a repeat of the live meeting capacity from last month, huh? Does anybody want to see a repeat from that disgusting episode again?
I'm going to walk back to Sherlock.
She thinks she's a writer.
What do you think you are?
Eat half of it.
Which half? They're both...
A quarter of it. 2 bites.
1 bite.
2 bites.
1 bite.
2 bites.
Okay.
But I know you.
If I eat 1 bite, you'll make me eat another bite. I'll take it up to my room and I'll eat it tonight. I need time to chew it.
Gene, if you didn't want it, you shouldn't have taken it. This is not the time to waste food.
I didn't take it, Pop.
They gave it to me.
Besides, I think it comes attached to the plate.
It's so important to everybody. I'll eat your liver, Eugene.
You will?
Seems to be the only thing this family is concerned about. Give me your liver so we can get on the more important things in our lives.
Nora's right. If nobody likes it, why do you make it?
Because we can't afford a roast beef for 7 people!
I suddenly felt very vulgar and cheap.
Stanley, come down.
Pop, can I just talk to you for a minute? It's really important. It's just coming up soon.
Hitler's already moving into Austria. In a couple of months, the whole world will be on. What's the matter with this radio?
Someone's been fooling around with this, haven't they, Eugene?
Why, Eugene? Pop had the news on last night, didn't he?
You weren't listening to the ball game this afternoon?
I don't want anyone touching this radio anymore. You understand?
Guess who's gonna get blamed for the war in Europe?
Eugene, bring the knife to the corpse.
Pop, you really think there's gonna be a war? I mean, like, America too?
We're already in it. Not us, maybe. But friends, relatives, if you're Jewish, you have someone suffering somewhere.
I know Kaczynski's family got out of Poland last month. The story she tells about what goes on over there, you don't even mind.
How many relatives?
Enough. Uncle's cousins. I have a great aunt. Your father and nephew.
His whole family.
What would happen if they came here and they were looking for a place to stay? Would we have to take them in?
Oh.
You know, your nephews, mom's cousins, uncles, everyone. Will we?
Well, God gives us to deal with.
Where we put them?
What are you worrying about things like that now for? Go upstairs and work on your speech.
What speech?
How are you going to ask Mr. Stroheim for a raise tomorrow?
Lou Gehrig got 2 hits today. Larrabee Lou is in 302.
Is that your paper? How many times I told you not to read it until your father is finished?
I didn't break him out. The print doesn't come over and take it late.
Upstairs. Pop. Everybody.
Such a pet!
Did everyone tell you that?
Yeah, I gotta listen to the room. You wanna add your name to it?
Why don't you lie down? There's nothing in that paper that's gonna cheer you up.
What will we do, Paige? If they knock on our house and our door tomorrow, what will we do? How will we feed them?
The boat did not get here yet. I can't deal with boats that haven't landed yet.
Uncle Jack, I know you're tired and you have a lot on your mind, so the rest of my life may depend on your decision. And I have to know tonight because I have to call Mr. Beckman and let him know if I can go to the audition.
Who's Mr. Beckman?
Now, Beckman, Dad, Rowan, Dad, and Dad, Nora, upstairs a minute.
Not now, Nora, this isn't the time.
It's never the time. You won't make a decision. I don't have anyone else I can talk to. Well, I'll make my own decision if no one's interested. I'm 16 and a half years old, and I'll do what I want to do.
What was that all about?
Go on out, Jack. Talk to her. I can do that. What are you going to tell her? That she can leave school? That she can throw her future away? Is that what you want to do? What is Eric supposed to say? What if she's got talent?
You can't talk to me. I'm her uncle, for God's sake.
She doesn't need an uncle tonight. She needs a father. Go on. She'll tell you.
I never learned.
Thank you.
their mother.
If you want to talk, we'll call. If not, no.
We've got enough mothers here. This is a family. The world does not survive without families. Lori, darling, do your homework. Blanche, you're making me some tea. You're the only one in this house that makes decent tea.
Listen, I know what it's like not to be heard.
You do?
I grew up in a family of four children. My father, before he died, never could remember our name. My older brother was the big one. I was the little one. My brother Sol was the rotten one, and Eddie was the skinny one.
So am I.
The pretty one. Now, what's the problem?
I don't know. It doesn't seem very important anymore.
I've never seen you cry for something that wasn't important. I know I'm not your father. It's not my place to make decisions for you. But I can offer advice. Advice is free. And if it doesn't fit, you can always return it.
Can we walk down the block?
Sure, we'll take a look at the ocean. My father always used to say, throw your problems out to sea, and they'll wash back up on shore.
Did they?
Not right, geez. Orange peels and watermelon pits were the only thing that washed up. That's why it's a good idea to bring someone to give good advice.
I'm sorry. I forgot it was this Tuesday. I'll change my doctor.
You don't have to change anything. The girls will be fine one day.
Have I ever missed a year going to the Grange? Dave was my favorite of the whole family. You know that.
You realize it'll be 6 years?
Sometimes I forget his birthday, but the day he died, I'll never forget. There wasn't another one like him.
Lori asked him questions all the time. Was he funny? What was the funniest thing she asked me? I couldn't answer. Isn't that terrible, Kate?
Sometimes you talk like your life is over. You're still a young woman. You're still beautiful. You never stop squinting so much.
I went with him 2 years before we were married. That was 2 million years I didn't have with him.
Listen, Jack's company is having their annual fair in New York next Wednesday at the Commodore Hotel. You should see how some of those women get dressed up. Jack wants you to come with us. He told me to ask you.
I mean, who do I know in Jack's company?
With thoughts, you'll meet people. Max Crane will be at our table.
He's the one who twice died last year from.
He's their number one talent. He lives in a hotel up Grand Concourse. He's a riot. You'll like him, and you'll dance him. What else are you going to do here every night?
I don't have a dress so wear to think like that.
You need something. Jack objections are material. He knows everybody in the garment district.
Thank you, Kate. I appreciate it. Maybe next year.
Next year, you won't have any eyes altogether. What are you afraid of, Blanche? Dave is dead. You're not. If God wanted the both of you, you'd be lying in the grave next to him.
I plan to next Wednesday.
More important than this? They have this affair once a year.
I'm having dinner with someone.
You're having dinner? With a man? That's wonderful. Why aren't you coming?
With Mr. Murphy.
Who's Mr. Murphy? Oh my God, I don't understand you. You're going to dinner with that man? Do you know he'll take you to a saloon? To a bar and grill. That's where he'll take you.
We're going to Shawdust, the Hungarian restaurant. You never even met the man. Why do you like him so much?
I don't have to meet that kind. I just have to smell his breath when he opens up the window. What do you think a man like that is looking for? I broke with that kind on Avenue A. How many times have Stan and Eugene come home black and blue from the beatings they took from those Irish hooligans? What have you got to talk to with a man like that?
Is that why you don't like him? Because he's Irish? When have the Jews and the Irish ever fought a war? Do you know who George Bernard Shaw is?
I don't care.
He's
who
one
he
of
is.
The greatest Irish writers. What would you say if he took me to Shawdust next Wednesday?
If Mr. might be a writer, tell him to bring me some of his books. I'll be glad to read them.
Kate, when are you going to stop being such an older sister?
I've heard stories about him with women. They like their women, you know. Well, if that's what you want, it's your business.
I decided to go downstairs and quiet my passion with some oatmeal cookies.
We took a walk along the beach last Thursday. He hardly said a word. He was very quiet, very shy. He told me where his parents came from in Ireland. You know, they didn't have it that much easier than Mom and Papa in Russia.
Nobody had it like they had it in Russia.
He holds a decent job and he didn't smell any liquor.
No cookies for you. Not until you finish that liver.
You mean, you're still saving it? It's gonna be the Xbox I like, Mama.
No cookies, you hear?
I just wanted a glass of water.
You have water in your bathroom.
There's toothpaste in the glass. It makes me nauseous.
Told me I'm a cracker. Told me I'm a
company to father this family. Everyone always comes to you with their problems. You have to give them the answer.
Stop trying to win me over. Just tell me what's wrong.
I got fired today.
What?
Don't get excited. Don't get crazy. Let me just explain what happened.
What happened? Did you come in late? Were you fresh to somebody?
I got my job back. I just need you to help me.
Take your job back, Stanley. This is not the time for anyone in this family to be out of work.
I was 12. You remember giving me a talk about principles?
All night you were going to go without telling this?
About principles, Pop.
How long were you going to go without telling this?
Principles.
All right, I'll hear your principles. Then you'll hear mine.
Just calm down. Just explain what happened, okay? There's a lot of kind of energy. Call about 6 o'clock.
So Stanley began his sad story. Pop never said a word. Just sat there and listened. Stanley was terrific. Not only was he defending his principles, but democracy in the United States of America. Pop must have been bleary-eyed because not only did he have to deal with Stanley's principles, Nora's career, Lori's fluttering heart, how to get Aunt Blanche in, married off. But any minute there could be a knock on the door from 27 relatives from Poland looking for a place to live. Finally, Stanley finished the story.
So, whether I bring them a letter of apology in the morning or don't even bother coming in.
Stanley.
I know.
You shouldn't have swept dirt on his shoes. Especially in front of the other people. He's your boss. He pays your salary. He helped put food on our dining room table.
I know, Pop.
On the other hand, you did a great thing. You stood up for a fellow worker. Nobody else stood up for him, did they?
No, I was the only one.
That's something proud of. That's standing up for your principal.
See, that's why I didn't want to write letters. I knew you'd understand.
But the question is, can this family afford principals right now?
Well, it would make it hot, I know. Listen, I know what you're doing. I'll go with it.
I'm not saying you should.
I know. It's my decision. I really do want to write the letter.
You know, Stanley, there's not much they could have taught you in college that you don't already know.
Guess what I learned, Pop. Pop, thanks for taking the time to talk. I'll see you in the morning. Are you coming to bed?
Nah, I think I'm gonna stay here a while. It's the only time of day I get to myself.
So, what's the decision? Do you have to write the letter?
Yep.
I know you make it do it.
Do it?
Aren't you?
Be quiet, I gotta concentrate.
Well, what are you gonna say? You know, people used to get paid for that in the old days, professional letter writers.
I'm not going to pay you.
I don't want money. What do you want? Tell me what Nora looked like naked.
How horny can you get it?
I don't know. What's the highest score?
No, I want to get paid first.
You're
such a bad
guy. Hey, don't hold the gun in front of me.
will be a 15-minute intermission. 15 minutes. Don't forget, snacks and drinks are available in the lobby, as is the 50-50 raffle.
Chin Colorman. And she's not as pretty as I thought she was.
Eugene, did you bring your father his paper?
I'm coming. My knee hurts. I fell in the stairs at school.
Well, bring it up. Your father's waiting for it.
If I just told her I lost both my hands in an accident, she'd say, go upstairs and wash your face with your feet. I guess she saw this. She and Pop came with the affair of Commodore Hotel. I mean, they have Glenn Rayner's orchestra. I feel kind of bad for her because she doesn't get out much. And I think she's a little nervous about Frank Murphy coming over here to pick up Aunt Blanche. Yep, she's just angry at the whole world. And that's why we're having lima beans for dinner tonight.
Would you like a cashew, Lori?
Oh, thanks. And a Brazil nut too. And
you must be stopped. We're having dinner in the kitchen tonight. We'll wait till your mother goes out.
Can I have some nuts, Mom?
Just one. It's for the company. We're eating dinner in the kitchen tonight. You and Stanley help the dishes. And stop eating my nuts. You look all flushed. You don't have a fever, do you? Let me see it, Tom. It's all splattered.
That's the cash.
Don't you get sick on me, too. If you're tired, I want you in bed.
Well, I have a little stomach cramp. Maybe I'm getting my ladies.
Your what?
My ladies, the thing that Nora gets when she can't go in the water.
I don't think so. Not at your age. But if your stomach hurts real bad, you come and tell me. I made a nice tuna fish salad tonight. Call me when your mother comes in.
Yeah, Kate. Does Mama like Mr. Mighty?
I don't know yet, darling. I don't think she knows him very well yet.
Well, do you like him?
I never spoke to the man.
You call him a Cossack. Those are kind of like Jewish people.
I'm sure Mr. Mighty likes your mother. Otherwise, he wouldn't be taking her out to dinner.
Well, if Mom married him, would we have to live in that dark house across the street with that creepy woman in the window?
We're not up to that yet. Let's just get through Shawdog's restaurant first.
Pop's feeling better. He threw the newspaper out of the day around the evening edition. You were terrible. The rats were already. You were crying.
I'm in trouble, Huge. I'm in really big trouble. Don't tell anyone about it. I promise you won't.
I take it open the entire life of the New York Yankees.
Well, what happened? I lost my salary.
What?
Entire $17. It's gone. He was where? In the subway? In a poker game? Are you serious?
What? Why were in his bedroom?
He never helped me a gamble stand. He just threw a lunch hour and pennies. I always won a dime, a quarter. It wasn't just lucky, Jane. I was really good. $17. Papa said, I want to try to make some extra money. You know, to help out. So I played this game over the stop before Sean Shoes. What did I know about poker? He cleaned me out in 20 minutes. Well, what are you going to tell Papa? I don't know. I wasn't so sick. I tell you the truth. Last week he's telling me how proud he is of me. And he's driving cabs at night while I'm playing poker at four times. Stanley, he just had bad luck, that's all. I mean, suppose you went to money. Suppose you won $50.
It was just bad luck.
I had no chance against those guys. They were gamblers. They wore black pointy shoes and clocks in the socks. If Pop dies, I'll hang myself.
Hey, Pop is not gonna die.
Besides, he ate three lamb chops for dinner tonight. Why didn't you say you had a hole in your pocket? You could tear a little hole in your pocket, can't you?
I used that.
When?
Back in November when I lost $5. Pop said from now on, check your pockets every morning.
Well, what happened to that $5, Stan? Did you gamble that away too?
No. I gave it to a little girl. You know. Pro.
Pro? A pro what?
Oh, what?
Oh, my God, what am I doing another place? You didn't tell me? Is that what it cost, $5?
$2.50.
Oh, was she like? Was she pretty? Did she have big
nose? Don't you stop me, Gene.
Did she get the money? You didn't tell me.
I'm about to tell you what a naked girl looks like. Do me a favor, Gene. Go into a bathroom and crawl by yourself.
Don't get so hot. If you were me, you'd ask me the same questions.
Yeah? I never had an older brother teach me those things. I had to learn all by myself. You don't know how lucky you are to be the younger one. You don't have the same responsibilities that I do. I bet you're still in school looking up girls' dresses on the stage.
Hey, I worked plenty hard in school.
Oh, yeah? Well, then show me your report card. This is the first of the month. I know you got it.
I don't have to show you. You're not my father.
Yes, I am. As long as Pop's sick, I'm the only one working in this house, ain't I?
Oh, really? Then where's your salary this week, Pop? I hate you sometimes. Nothing but a lousy one. God.
I hate you all the time. You never help me without ever wanting something for it. I hate you disgusting.
Not as much as I hate yours. You snore and I can pick your toenails. You smell of the bathroom. When I go in there, I have to puke.
Give me your report card. Give me your beach of
your wife. Here it is, you lousy smug.
Want to kill yourself, Jack? You want to leave me here to take care of this family loan? Is that what you want?
You think I'll get better today? four is enough for your kid. If I need more, I'll ask you.
I'm sorry. You know me. I'm not happy unless I can worry. My family were worriers. Worriers generally marry fainters.
If I haven't left you for another woman, I'm certainly not going to drop that business.
What other woman? That bookkeeper, Helene?
Again, Miss Helene, you're never going to forget that I danced with her 2 years in a row at the Commodore Hotel.
Don't tell me she isn't attracted to you. I noticed that right off.
What's she want with me? She likes a salesman, the man up front. Besides, she's a widow. She's looking to get married.
You're an attractive man, Jack. Women like you.
Me? Attractive? You really must think I'm not.
You don't know women like I do. Just promise me one thing. If anything ever happened with you and that Helene, let me go to the grave without hearing it.
Oh, so now since you have your bad Helene, you figured you're gonna die first?
I had to chop the ice. I'm out of breath.
It's exercise.
I'm going out. I won't be having dinner. I'll be home late. I have my tea. Good night.
Nora, don't you want to see how your mother will?
I'm sure she will. Well, she doesn't need me to tell her.
But what about Mr. Murphy? I know your mother wants him to meet you and Laura.
I have somebody waiting for me. I can meet Mr. Murphy some other time.
Nora, I think it'd be nice if you waited for your mother. She'd be very upset with you.
I'm sure that's very good advice, Uncle Jack. I know just how my mother feels. I'm not so sure she knows how I feel.
Jack, what'll I do?
Let it go, Katie. It's something Blanche and Nora have to work out.
Who does she go out with? Where does she go every night?
With Larry Clurman. He borrows his father's car and takes her to the cemetery.
What cemetery?
Where Daddy is buried. He goes to see Daddy.
What do I tell her? I don't want to spoil this evening for her.
Oh, Jack, what are you doing down here?
I'm trying to finish my bed. I wanted to come down.
I looked in your room. I got scared to death.
Oh, Blanche! Oh my God, Blanche! It's stunning! Like a movie star!
Who's that movie star I like so much, Lori?
Irene Dunne.
Like Irene Dunne.
I think she looks like Rosalind Russell. Maybe Carol Lombard.
I think she looks like Blanche. Blanche is prettier than all of us.
I had such trouble with my makeup. I couldn't see to put my mascara on, so I put on my glasses, and then I couldn't get the mascara on my
glasses. Where are your glasses?
I put them in my purse. I thought I'd put them on when I'm looking at the menu.
Make sure you do. I don't want you coming home telling me you don't know what he looks like.
I'm so glad to see you. Jack, then you're feeling better?
It was nothing. I needed a rest, that's all. Besides, when a stranger walks in, he likes to meet another man. It makes him feel more comfortable.
Oh, that's very thoughtful of you, Jack.
Here. Wear these. Don't say no to me. Just put them
on. Hey, you're Pearl. You're good Pearl.
What are they going to do? Sit in my drawer all year? Pearls are like like to go out and be seen once.
I forgot you were gonna wear them to the dance night. I'm so wrapped up in myself, I forgot you were missing it.
I can even afford to miss it. I don't see Jack there the whole night anyway.
I'm so nervous, I'll lose them.
All right, now don't tell me I have a beautiful sister.
Definitely Carol Lombard.
Lori, go on up and get Nora. I want to show them the Nora. What do you mean she left without saying goodbye?
She had to meet somebody. She wanted to wait for you.
She could have come in my room. She knew I wanted to see her.
She'll see you when you get home tonight. You look just as pretty as Paul Fox.
What is she saying? Did she say anything?
If you're going out, you're going to have a good time tonight.
She's making me pay for this, isn't she? She knows how to get to me so easily.
Do you feel like ice cream?
But if you can.
But if you can for you, maybe one up for me. Go run upstairs and ask Eugene to go to Hanson.
I'll go with them.
Don't run, darling.
Let her run. If she gets tired, she'll tell you. Let's stop worrying about each other's problems so much.
Eugene, your father wants us to go to the store.
Tell him my stomach hurts. I don't feel good.
You don't want any ice cream?
Ice cream? It's amazing how quickly you recover from misery when someone offers you ice cream.
She's only 16, Blanche. At that age, they're all wrapped up in themselves.
How am I going to become a writer if I don't know how to suffer? Actually, I'd give up anything in the world if I could see a naked girl while eating ice cream.
What time is it? 6:90. We'll be here at minute. Get your mind off the world, man. Don't wear my pearls out tonight for nothing.
Eugene, go to Hanson's. Get a half pint of butter pecan, a half pint of maple walnut, half pint of chocolate for yourself. Kate, what do you want?
I'm in no mood for ice cream.
Get some vanilla. Chill it.
I need money, Papa.
I just paid the doctor $15. Go run upstairs and ask Stanley for a salary.
What?
Ask him for his salary.
Here. Here's a dollar. Hurry back so Lori can meet Mr. Mikey. But don't run. You know what I worry about at night? That she'll run off. That I'll wake up in the morning and she'll be gone. To Philadelphia, to Boston, or who knows where.
Look how the woman's going out. Is that what you're going to talk about? The man will start drinking in 5 minutes.
You think so? What do I do? Because sure.
You'll come right home. Do you have money? Do you have car fare?
No, I didn't take anything with you. I'll get $5 from Stanley. Now I have something else to worry about.
Sit there, I'll make it.
We'll both make it. We can hear the doorbell from the kitchen.
Stanley. Are you in there? Open up a window. You never get any air in this room. I need $5 for your rent, Blanche. Stanley, did you get paid today?
Yeah, I got paid today.
Okay, take out your money quickly. Let me have the envelope.
I don't have it.
You don't have the envelope?
I mean, I don't have the money.
What do you mean you don't have the money?
I don't have the money. It's gone.
Gone? Gone where?
I mean, it's gone. I don't have it. I can't get it back. So don't ask me any more questions about it, all right?
Don't ask any more questions. I want to know what happened to $17, Stanley.
Don't tell Pop. If I tell you, you're going to tell Pop.
Why shouldn't I tell you, Father? Why, Stanley? I want to know what happened to that money.
I gambled it. I lost the playing poker. All right? Happy? Satisfied now?
I'm not going to deal with this right now. I have to get your Aunt Blanche out of the house first, and I have your Uncle Jack to help with work. You are going to sit in this room, and you're going to think of the story. You were robbed. Somebody stole the money from you. I don't care who, and I don't care where. That's what you're going to do. Because if you tell your father the truth, you will kill that man as sure as I'm standing here. Tonight, after everyone goes to sleep, you will meet me in that kitchen, and we'll deal with this alone.
Sorry.
I left my purse in here without my glasses. I can barely see a thing.
Okay, what is it? What's wrong?
Nothing. I'm just all nerves.
You're worried about Jackie? Should have come down the stairs.
He knows he's not supposed to. What do we need a doctor for? He doesn't even listen to him.
It's Mr. Mobley. I should have asked him to come over.
It's not just Mr. Mobley. It's Stanley. It's Eugene. It's everybody.
I'm sorry about Nora. Jack told me what she said before she left.
Why don't you get your purse, Blanche? He'll be here any minute.
Did Nora say anything to hurt you, Kay? I know she's been very difficult this past week.
Why is it always Nora? Why is it always your problems? Do you think you're the only one in this world who has troubles? We all have troubles. We all get our equal share.
Sorry, forgive me, I'm sorry.
Maybe you're stronger than I am. I don't know. You survived Dave's death. I don't know if I can handle it, if anything ever happened to Jack.
Nothing's gonna happen to him, Kay. He's still a young man. He's strong.
When Dave died, I cried for his loss. I was so angry. Angry at God for taking such a young man. I never realized it until now what you must have gone through. How did you get through it, Blanche?
And you. And Jack. But mostly, you live for your children. Your children keep you going.
My children?
I wake up every day for Nora and for Lori.
Nora hurts you so much, and you can still say that.
Why, don't you think we hurt our parents when we were little? Do you remember her? Mom used to cry when Celia left? Sure, it hurts, but if you love someone, you forgive them.
Some things you forgive, and some things you never forgive.
Is the ice cream here yet?
Why didn't you go with Eugene?
No, I was across the street in that creepy house. Just the see the inside.
You in the market house? Why are you in there?
She called me in from the window, the old lady. I think it's his mother. She said she had a letter for you. I had to go in to get it.
What did she say? Did she say anything?
Well, she offered me a cookie, but it was all green. I said I wasn't hungry.
Dear Mrs. Morgan, I send regrets for my son, Frank. I tried to reach you early and then realized you had no phone. Frank will be unable to keep his dinner engagement with you this evening, because Frank is in the hospital as a result of an automobile accident last week. And although the injuries are not serious, the consequences are. The voting on right way is unhuman. Forward my apologies. Despite all my son's faults, honesty and sincerity have never been one of his failings. But he wanted me to tell you the truth. And while driving a friend's motor car last week, he was intoxicated. That was the cause of the accident. He knew the truth would come out soon enough. Frank has too much respect and fondness for you to have care from some of his souls. Those most respectful. This is Matthew Mercer.
What is it? He's not coming. He's in the hospital.
It was a sad letter, all right. But it sure was well written. Hey, maybe I should have been born in Ireland.
I knew it. I said it right from the beginning. Oh, God, that poor woman.
Does that mean you're not going out to dinner?
It could have been you in that car with him. I warned you the first day about those people.
God holy, that those people. They're not those people. She's a mother like you and me.
What is he? Tell me what
he is. He's somebody in trouble. He's somebody that needs help. For God's sake, can you tell me?
I know that. I know what they're all like.
And who are we to talk? Are we something so special? We're all poor around here. The least we can do is be charitable.
Why? What have I got that I can afford to give away? Am I the one who got you dressed up tonight for nothing? Am I the one who got your hopes up? Am I the one that they're going to go throw away and lock up in jail somewhere?
Are you in jail?
Don't talk to me about charity. Anyone else but not me.
I never said you were charitable.
All I did was try to help you. All I ever did was try to help you.
I know that. Nobody cares for their family more than you do, Kate. At least you can be charitable. Someone else in trouble.
Who should I care about? Who is out there watching over me? I did enough in my life for people. You know what I'm talking about.
No, I don't. Say what's under my feet. What people?
You! Celia! Papa when he was sick! Everybody! Don't you ask me what people! How many beatings did I get from Mama for the things that you did? How many dresses did I go without so you can look like someone when you went out? I was the work horse and you were the pretty one. You have no right to talk to me like that. No right.
This is about Jack, isn't it? You're blaming me for what happened.
Why do you think that man is sick today? Why did a policeman have to carry him home at 2 o'clock in the morning? So you're Nora could have dancing lessons? So that Laurie could see a doctor every 3 weeks? Go on, worry about your friend across the street, not the ones that can be dragged home to keep a roof over your head.
What is this? What's going on here?
Why didn't you ever tell me you felt that way?
I never had the time. I was too busy taking care of everybody.
What is this, Blanche? What's wrong?
It took all those years. It took something like that letter for you to finally get your feelings out.
I didn't need a letter. I just needed you to ask me.
Lori, go upstairs. The conversation isn't for you.
The ice cream
you
is
ready. You did put the ice cream in the ice box. I had to talk to your mother.
I've never spoken. I've lived in the house for 3 years and I've never exchanged one word.
What are you walking around for? If you had a bed, at least sit in a chair.
If I could take Nora and Lori and pack them out of this house tonight, I would do it. But I can't. I have no place to take them.
Please don't say such things.
The girls can stay with you for a little while. I would appreciate it. Until I can
You're not sending for anyone, and you're not going anywhere. I don't want to hear this.
Stay out of this, Jack. Let her do what she wants. I know a woman in Manhattan Beach. I can stay with her for a few days. I'll do anything anybody asks me, and I'll never be a burden to anyone again.
Stop this, Blanche. Stop it right now. What the hell is going on here, for God's sake? Two sisters having a fight they should have had 25 years ago. You want to get it out, Blanche? Get it out. Tell them what it's like to live in a house that isn't yours. Have to depend on someone else to put food on your plate every night. I know what it's like, because I lived like that until I was 21 years old. Go on, Kate. Tell her what it's like to be the older sister, to be the one who has to burden all the responsibilities, and not be the one who gets the hugs and infection. You don't think I see this with Stanley and Eugene? With Laura and Nori? You don't think I hear the fights that go on in those rooms night after night? Go on, Kate. Scream at it. Yell at it. Tell her to go to hell for the first time in your life, Blanche. And when you both get out of your systems, give each other a hug, and let's eat dinner. That lousy ice cream smell, for God's sake.
I love you both very much. No matter what Kate says to me, I'll never stop loving her. But I have to get out. If I don't get out now, I'll lose whatever self-respect I have left. But people like us, sometimes the thing we really own is our dignity. And when I grow old, I'd like to have as much as Mrs. Murphy across the street.
What did it, Kate? Something terrible must have happened tonight to make you act this way. It wasn't Blanche. What was it?
Tell the kids to come down in 5 minutes. We're eating dinner in the kitchen tonight.
Tell Stanley and Lori dinner will be ready in 5 minutes.
Blanche is leaving in the morning.
Leaving? Where?
I don't know. To stay with some woman in Manhattan Beach. She and Mott just had this big fight, and she's going to send for Nora and Lori when she gets herself a job.
Did you say anything about me and how I lost my salary?
You told her? Why'd you tell her I came up with 12 terrific lines for you?
How much money?
Me, I don't have any money.
I got money in Starbucks.
It's $1.12 in my life savings.
Let me have it. Pay you back.
Years ago from the 100-yard dash.
Sure.
Thank you. Where are you going to stay, even?
I don't know. Pop says there's going to be a war in a couple of years, so I can go ahead and join that. And I could be a sergeant by the time it starts.
You know, if it lasts long enough, I could join too. We could be in the same outfit together, Stan.
You don't join the army unless they come for you, all right? You go to college. I promise me you go to college.
You probably have to stay home and work.
If you leave, we'll need the money.
I'll send all my pitch every month.
Sergeant in the army makes really good dough.
They have the gold war.
Don't start crying. They'll hear you. Gene, take care of yourself, all right? This very minute is the end of my childhood. When Stanley walked out that door, I knew that time had come to me. I was scared, and I was lonely, and I hated my mother and father for making them so unhappy. Even if they were right, I still hated them. I even hated Stanley a little too because he left me for a walk by myself.
Eugene, Lori, it's dinner. I'm not waiting all night.
And I hated him too. Believe in his name, I want you all this to dinner. I don't think parents realize how cool that can be sometimes. Dinner, I tried to tell them about Stanley, but the words just never came out. I left the table without even having my ice cream, and if it was suffering I was after, I was sure beginning to learn a lot about it.
Where's Stanley so late?
Never mind, Stanley. You should have been in bed an hour ago.
Something happened between you and that boy that you're not telling me.
I'm tired, Jack. I've had enough to deal with for one day.
I want them to go to temple with me this Saturday. They stop going for 3 or 4 weeks. They forget their religion altogether.
The house has become quieter than I ever heard it before. And Blanche was in her room packing. Mom and Pop were in their bedroom. And I had to talk to someone or I'd go crazy. And I didn't have very much choice. Hey, Lori, it's Eugene. Can I come in?
What do you want? I'm reading.
I just wanted to
talk to you. I didn't say yes, did I?
Well, I'm already in, so it's too late. But what are you reading?
The Citadel by A.J. Conan.
Well, I read it. It's terrific. I hear your mother's leaving in the morning.
We're going to.
As soon as she finds a job.
I can't believe that I'm going to be the only one left here.
Maybe you and Stanley.
Stanley's gone. He's not coming back. I think he's going to go join the army.
He ran away?
Only kids run away. Stanley's age, you. Just go.
He didn't
take
the
phone. My parents don't even know about you. Gotta go in and tell them now.
I wonder if I'll have to go to a different school.
You'll have to make all new friends.
Well, I don't care. I don't have any friends here anyway.
Because you're always in the house, you never go out.
I can't because of my condition.
You don't look sick to me. Do you feel sick?
No. My mother tells me I am.
Don't trust parents anymore.
Why would she lie to me?
to keep you around? Once they find out Stanley's gone, they're gonna handcuff me to my bed.
Well, I would leave my mother anyway. Even when I'm older, even if I get married, I'll never leave my mother.
Yeah. Mr. Murphy across the street never left his mother. And now he's going to jail.
None of this would have happened if my father was alive.
How did you feel when he died?
Well, I don't remember. I cried a lot because I saw my mother crying.
I would sure hate it if my father died. Especially with Stanley gone. I'll have to move out of this house.
Well, then you and your mother could come and live with us.
So, if we're all going to end up living together in the end, what's the point of breaking up now, right?
I don't know. I have to finish reading.
You don't get too far talking to Laurie. Sometimes I think the flood in her heart is really in her brain. So I went to their bedroom and broke the news. The monumental news. Stanley had run off. Probably be killed in France fighting for his country. You know, my mother says to me, go ahead. He'll be home when it gets cold out. I couldn't believe it. Her own son. And it was suddenly then that I suspected that Stanley and I were adopted. So I go out front, and I wait till it gets cold. And I weep. And wait. Stanley never came home.
Wanted to talk to you.
Now? It's late.
I know it's late. We could have talked earlier if you didn't come home at 12 o'clock at night.
How was your dinner?
I didn't go. Mr. Murphy was in next.
I'm sorry.
Is he all right? He's got his problems like the rest of us. I was very hurt you left tonight without saying goodbye.
I was late. Somebody was waiting.
So was I. You knew it was important to me.
I'm not feeling very well.
You purposely left without saying goodbye. You've never done that before.
We talked about this in the morning. I'm leaving, Nora.
Then tomorrow night. I'm leaving, Nora. I'm moving out in the morning. And Kate and I had a huge fight tonight. We said some terrible things to each other, things I've been bottled up since we were children. I'm going to stay with my friend Louise in Manhattan Beach until I can find a job. And then I'll send for you and Lori.
I can't believe it. You mean it's okay for you to leave us? It wasn't okay for me to leave you?
Never concerned about you leaving me, Nora. It was your future.
It was my future, and why couldn't I have something to say about it?
Maybe I was wrong. I don't know. I never made the decision as a family. Your father did. Everyone always took care of me. My mother, my father, even you and Lori. I've been a very dependent person all my life.
Maybe that's all I'm asking. To be independent.
You earn your independence. You don't take it at the expense of others. Would that job even be off you if someone had to put a roof over your head or clothes on your back? If anyone's gonna pay back Jack, it'll be me. Doing God knows what, I don't know, but one thing I'm sure of, I'd steal before I let my daughter show 1 ounce of ingratitude or disrespect.
So I have to give up the one chance I may never get again, is that it? I have to pay for what you can do with your own life.
What would you like to have to judge me?
Judge you? I can't even talk to you. I don't exist to you. I tried so hard to get close to you, but there was never any room. Whatever you had to give went to Daddy, it was me that was there.
What? Finish what you were gonna say.
I've been jealous for my whole life in Florence because she was lucky enough to be born sick. I could never turn a light on in my room or read at night because Lori needed her precious sleep. I could never have a friend over on the weekends because Lori was always resting. I used to pray I'd get some terrible disease or get hit by a car so I'd have a leg all twisted and crippled. So that once, maybe just once, I'd get to crawl into bed next to you on a cool, rainy night and hold you in my arms until I fell asleep. Just once.
My God, Lauren, is that what you think of me?
Is it any worse than what you think of me?
I'm not gonna let you hurt me, Nora. I'm not gonna let you try to tell me that I don't love you, or I haven't tried to give you as much as I gave Lori. God knows I'm not perfect, because enough angry people told me so in this house tonight. I'm not gonna be a doormat to all the frustrations and anger that you or Aunt Kate or anyone else wants to lay at my feet. I did not create the universe. I did not decide who lives or who dies, who's rich or who's poor, who feels loved and who feels deprived. If you feel cheated that Lori gets more than you, then I feel cheated that a husband died at 36. And if you keep on living that way, you'll end up like me, with something much less than loneliness or helplessness, and that self-pity. Believe me, there is no lame or crippling or bent any human that thrives on his own misfortune. Sorry, Nora. I'm sorry that you feel unloved, and I'll do everything I can except apologize for it. Apologizing. After a while, it becomes your life's work and it doesn't bring any money into the house. But if it's taking your pain and Aunt Kate's anger to get me to start living again, then God will give me the strength to make it up to you. I will not go back to being that frightened, helpless woman that I created. I buried someone I loved. Now it's time to bury someone I hate. I do, Nora. Why can't I make that clear to you? Why?
Because I think I hurt you, and I still want that job, Mr. Bell.
I know you do.
But I can't have it.
How can I answer that without you feeling like I'm still depriving you?
I don't know. Maybe you just do.
I hope so, Nora. I pray to God it's so.
I heard voices downstairs. I didn't know who it was.
I'm sorry if we woke you. Nora, going off to bed. We'll discuss this in the morning.
All right.
Yes.
She's not angry.
No, no one's angry anymore, Kate. I just explained everything to Nora. The girls will help you with the housework. I've kept Lori and baby long enough.
They've never been any trouble to me, those girls. Never.
I'll try to take them on the weekends if I can. Look, it's late. We both deserve a good night's sleep.
Blanche, don't go. I feel badly enough for what I said. Don't make me feel any worse.
Everything you said to me tonight was the truth, Kate. I wish to God you said it years ago.
What would I do without you? Who else do I have to talk to? What friends do I have in this neighborhood? Even the Mifeys across the street are leaving.
The girls I'm thinking of now, we have to be together, the three of us.
All right. I'm not saying you shouldn't have it, but you're not going to find a job overnight. Apartments are expensive. Why are you looking? Why do you have to live with strangers in Manhattan Beach?
Louise isn't a stranger. She's a good friend.
To me, good friends are strangers, but sisters are sisters.
I'm afraid of becoming comfortable here. If I don't get out now, what will I ever?
The door is open. Go whenever you want. When you find a job, when you got the apartment, I'll help you move in. I know how to bargain with these landlords.
You wouldn't mind doing that?
I see a woman all alone. They take advantage of you. I'll see what they're asking for the nightly place. Couldn't be that expensive. She never cleaned it.
How independent can I become if I'm afraid across the street from you?
Far enough away for you to close your own door, and close enough for me to not feel so lonely.
I lived on the moon, Kate. Still be close enough.
I'll tell Jack. If you wouldn't go to sleep tonight without hearing some good news.
I suddenly feel so hungry.
Of course, you haven't had anything to eat. Come on, I'll fix you some scrambled eggs.
I'll do it. I'm an independent woman now.
With your eyes, you'll never get the eggs on the tan.
So Aunt Blanche decided to stay while she was looking for a job. And Nora, she went back to school the next morning. Smile on her face, gave me a big hug. And her legs looked as creamy white as ever. Lauren was asked to take out the garbage, but she quickly got a flood in her heart, so I had to deal with it. Life was back to normal.
Eugene, go back to Greenblatt's. I need flour.
How much a teaspoonful? No. Stanley never came home that night. And although Mom didn't say anything, I knew she was plenty worried. She told Pop how Stan lost money playing poker, and from the sounds coming out of their bedroom, I thought they should forget about the army, and Stanley should try for the Foreign Legion. And then he came back. I was never so happy to see anyone in my life.
Hey, where's Mom?
Mom's in the kitchen cooking, and Pop prepared with his prayer book. They figured if God didn't bring it home, Mom's potato pancakes would. So did you join up?
Came pretty close. Past physical wants to drink.
I knew you would.
They're giving me cigarettes, donuts, the whole sales pitch. They really mind me.
Okay.
Then, just now it's about the summer, I stopped calling. I told the man, sorry, maybe some other time. I walked out.
Why?
Kind of done it to Pop. Well, he needs me now more than the young days. Plus, I knew Mom didn't really mean it. She said she wouldn't forgive me for losing my salary. If I walk down this family now, maybe she'd like me.
I guess so. Well, I'm really glad you're home, Stan.
Jean, go back to Green Glass. I need a pint of sweet cream and some more sugar.
Stanley's home, Mom.
I know.
Get a 2-pound bag. I want to bake a chocolate.
A 2-pound bag from Green Glass? I'll need identification.
Are you staying for dinner?
Stay as long as you'll let me stay.
Why wouldn't I let you stay? This is your home. Your father's been very worried about you. I think he owed him some sort of explanation.
I was just about to go. Hey, Pop, how you feeling? Listen, I know what's wrong with me to walk out of the family. I just don't know how to tell you I wasn't a sour. I know it doesn't help to tell you that I'm going to do it again. Because I won't. Listen, I made $3 sending the pins at until midnight. I thought I went to bowling alley. I can make another 6 on the weekend, so that makes 9. Pop, I'm gonna get the money back, I promise. Because I'm not afraid of hard work, I'm not. Those are two things taught me a lot. Hard work and principles. It's what I'm gonna live by for the rest of my life. So.
Did you read the paper today, Stanley?
You know, Pop.
There's gonna be a war. A terrible war.
I know.
The biggest war the world has ever seen. And it scares me. We're not over the last one yet. That day will come soon enough, I'm afraid.
Well, I did think about it. I mean, it was on my mind.
You know, Stanley, there's nothing you could do that was so terrible that I wouldn't be able to forgive you. I know why you gambled. I know how bad you felt. It was foolish. You already know that.
Well, Pop, you never hung on me. You know that, and you're always fair.
I try to be, Stanley. You're a good kid. You don't know that.
I gambled away $17, and you started telling me how terrific I am.
Hey, wait a minute. If you were here last night, I would have thrown you and your clothes out the window. But today, I'm calmer. Today, I read the paper. Today, I'm afraid for all of us.
I understand, Pop.
Tonight after dinner, you apologize to your mother and give her the $3.
I will.
And apologize to Aunt Blanche, too. She was upset.
I will.
And you can thank your brother Eugene. He came into our room and told us how badly he felt. He was almost in tears himself. The way he pleaded your case, thought we had Clarence there on the room.
Well, Eugene's a terrific kid.
All right, Stanley. Go wash up and get ready for dinner. And tonight, I'm going to teach you how to play poker.
All right.
Back yet?
No, I don't think so, Mom.
You look tired. Did you get any sleep last night?
I got enough. I slept at a friend's house. Mom, can I talk to you at the dinner?
Where am I going? To a nightclub?
Run for green lights. Next year I'm entering in the grocery store Olympics.
Is that my sweet cream?
Yes. Never spilled a drop. The perfect run. Here's some nail for you, Pop. Where's Stanley?
He's washing up. God, I got jury duty next week.
Well, you back in the family?
Yep.
Sure, things great. Say, you want to take a walk on the beach tonight and see what's doing? Doing what? Oh. Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm serious. Right after dinner.
I don't believe you.
What is I got to do with
you? You're crazy, Stanley. You're genuinely crazy. If you lose, I'm not sticking up for you this
time. Keep it quiet. Looking for the present.
The present?
Can you tell anyone?
No, what's my present?
Puberty's over! Onwards and upwards!